In this video, I am going to explain important membrane connection of heart. You know, heart is surrounded by pericardium. Pericardium. And this membrane has various connection to many places. So I am going to explain its continuation. First thing, there is muscle below heart. What is this yellow one? This is diaphragm. Diaphragm. You know, heart is above diaphragm. And heart is stabilized by membrane, connective tissue. This connective tissue is elongation from pericardium. So, heart and diaphragm is connected. Think about it. You know, heart moves a lot in a day. What happens if this place is not connected? Heart can go anywhere. Maybe that can compress lungs, that can go up or down any direction. That is why this place needs to be stabilized, because diaphragm moves a lot in the day as well. With that said, when diaphragm lowers down and goes upper, heart should move with diaphragm, right? Because it's connected. Now, if diaphragm is tight, if your diaphragm cannot function well, maybe this tension can go to pericardium. What happens then? Heart is inside of thorax. If this membranous connection is restricted, that may inhibit movement of thorax. Of course, breathing. I am not saying tight membrane affects function and physiology of heart. That's quite not possible. You know, tight membrane cannot induce like a stroke, you know, like a high blood pressure. Maybe that can affect these kind of physiology, but it's not very clear. You know what I mean? But this membranous connection may affect function of rib cage. This is very important connection. Anyway, this membrane between heart and diaphragm is called frenopericardial ligament. Frenopericardial ligament. Freno means diaphragm. Pericardial means pericardium. Easy, right? Connective tissue between diaphragm and pericardium. Is that okay? Now let's move on to the next one. This is profile view. This is heart. There should be bone in front of heart. This is sternum. Pericardium and sternum has connection as well. Like this and this. Superior part and inferior part. Superior part is superior sternopericardial ligament. Superior sternopericardial ligament. Oh my gosh, it's very long name. What about inferior one? It is inferior sternopericardial ligament. It's quite simple, right? So, what happens if this membrane is restricted? Maybe movement of sternum can be restricted. What happens then? Maybe that can affect breathing, core stability. It may inhibit movement of thorax. Particularly, sternum oftentimes get trauma and shock from car accident or sports like American football or rugby football or maybe martial arts, sternum should be very flexible. But when you get heavy trauma, that can affect sternum and maybe this membrane. Now this membranous tension can affect pericardium. Does it make sense? Superior sternopericardial ligament, inferior sternopericardial ligament. Oh, by the way, today's ligament is not on usual anatomy books. But if you Google this ligament, you can see pictures. So please go for that. Now, next ligament. Next one is pericardium to vertebra, particularly lower cervical area. This ligament is vertebropericardial ligament. Vertebropericardial ligament, particularly on lower cervical spines. Again, if somehow pericardium gets tight or this membrane ligament gets tight, that can affect diaphragm, sternum, and cervical spines. Particularly, all the tissues today is in front of spines. That means if these anterior tissues get tight, that can bring cervical spines forward. Thoracic spines get to forward. So this kind of forward position can be induced by this connective tissue. You know, these are very, very important. Now let me explain the last one. The last one is pericardium and thyroid gland. Thyroid gland. There is ligament between pericardium and thyroid. What is the name of this ligament? This is thyropericardial ligament. Thyropericardial ligament. Or if you can't find thyropericardial ligament on Google, you can type thyropericardial lamina. Maybe this word may give you a picture of this ligament. Okay? Pericardium and thyroid gland. Oh my gosh, heart has many membranous connection with many things. Diaphragm, sternum, vertebra, and thyroid gland. Of course, heart is related to lungs, phrenic nerve, vagus nerve, so many things. But I just focus on kind of a bony structure, muscles, and other organs such as thyroid gland. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.